These are ceramic capacitors, and these are electrolytic capacitors. The difference is that these have polarity. You cannot connect them opposite. They have positive and negative, while these can be connected anyhow. Hello there, my name is Dominic, and today I'm going to show you how to protect your small speakers from big powered amplifiers. The speakers I've connected over here are very low power speakers. This one is rated at 5 watts, maximum 7 watts. Same with this one. I've protected this speaker using a ceramic capacitor connected in series to the positive terminal into the speaker. Let me connect the other one real quick so that you can hear a difference. So you can hear this one is producing sort of like a Twitter sound, and this one like a more or less like a full range sound. So for those few seconds, this speaker is really smelling. It has a strong burning smell. If I continue using this speaker at that volume, it will just burn up. But this speaker is okay because it's protected using this capacitor. So let me connect this electrolytic capacitors or polar capacitors across this other terminal real quick so that you can hear the difference. So you can hear there's different frequencies when I use different type of capacitors. So do not use these types of capacitors because these are polar capacitors, and from what we know, speaker outputs or amplifier outputs produce an AC signal. So these polar capacitors with this line denoting that this is the negative terminal and the other side over here being the positive terminal. Same case for the other ones. This is the negative terminal over here, and the other one over the other side is the positive terminal. So don't use these types of capacitors. You can buy what are known as non-polar capacitors, like the one they use in coaxial speakers. This is a car audio speaker. It has this capacitor over here. So this capacitor is for protecting this small speaker on top here. This is the woofer, and this is the mid-range speaker, and that's the tuner over there. So the tuner and mid-range speaker are protected by this capacitor over here. If we check real closely, don't know if you can see, this is a 4.7 microfarad capacitor. So that speaker is protected. So now that you know how to protect your speakers, let me show you a very simple formula that you can use to create a much better cutoff frequency for your speakers. So we've seen that this is a 4.7 microfarad capacitor, and the impedance of this speaker is 4 ohms. So these are the two values you are going to use. This is capacitance and this is the resistance. So the formula for cutoff frequency is 1 over 2 pi RC. The R is the resistance and the C is the capacitance. So when you calculate 1 over 2 pi 4 times 4 times 4.7, this is micro, so you have to convert it to farads by 10 to power minus 6. So when we do this, we get the value to be around 8470 hertz. So anything higher than this frequency, this is the tuner sound that will be played by this speaker. It will cut off any frequencies below this. So, but this woofer is free to play the full range of frequencies, but it only excels at low frequencies, the boom boom sound, like the woofer sounds. So that is how you calculate the cutoff frequency. The circuit diagram being like this. So I'm using the impedance of the speaker. This is the capacitor and this is the resistor. I'm using the resistance of the speaker in this case because our measurements are calculated from this point. This is where you calculate the cutoff frequency from this point, the output. So thanks for watching and goodbye.